We are left with the first five questions from this exercise. I hope you've completed the work I gave you and you did try question seventh on your own once.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Question numbers first to five. I'm starting with fifth question. In a triangle, we are given angle C equals to 3 times angle B, which is equal to 2 times angle A plus angle B. You have to find out three angles. In general, if out of the three angles of a triangle, if any one is missing, we apply angle sum property. But right here, all three angles are missing. And as I told you, the number of missing values there are. You need to have that number of linear equations in order to find out the values for each. अब यहाँ पे आपके पास तीन एंगल्स मिसिंग हैं, तो आपको तीन इक्वेशंस चाहिए। एंड सिंस वी आर वर्किंग विद लीनियर इक्वेशन इन टू वेरिएबल्स, वी हैव द चॉइस टू रिप्रेजेंट एनी ऑफ द टू एंगल्स विद टू डिस्टिंक्ट वेरिएबल्स। सो आउट ऑफ ए बी सी यू कैन रिप्रेजेंट ए एंड बी विद एक्स एंड वाई रिस्पेक्टिवली। आफ्टरवर्ड्स फॉर सी यू कैन यूज एंगल सम प्रॉपर्टी, यू कैन एक्सप्रेस एंगल सी इन टर्म्स ऑफ एक्स एंड वाई। एंड देन आउट ऑफ दीज relations given, आपके पास angle C equals to 3 times angle B equals to 2 times angle A plus angle B है। इसको use करके आप pairs में दो equations और बना सकते हो। Remember, every time you're given such kind of relationship, it resembles the relation between the ratios of the coefficients. आपके पास तीन values हैं जो आपस में equal हैं, आप इनको pairs में लेके there are three possible pairs. You can take any two to obtain two equations. So take the first one with the second one with the third one. You will get two relations. Other than that, we are representing angle A as X, B as Y. For angle C, I'm using angle sum property. Angle sum property of triangle states that the sum of these three equals to 180 degrees. From here, angle C can be represented in terms of X and Y. So while forming your linear equations, use these values. Angle C equals to 3 times angle B. Angle C is 180 degree minus X plus B equals to 3 times Y. Simplify. Obtain your linear equation. Did anyone try this?
Yes, ma'am.
Rohan, did you try this way or you have done it in some other way?
No, ma'am. I have calculated that A plus B is 180 degrees minus C.
Okay.
So then in that relation, I get 9B is equals to 360 and B is in angle 40.
Okay.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, I have done it ma'am, by replacing C two times in an equation, equating it to 180. Ma'am, like 2 into A plus B plus A plus B equals to 180 and A plus B plus 3B equals to 180.
Okay. So you may solve, you have your value of Y directly from here if we just use substitution. X comes out to be 20 degrees. This means Y equals to 40 degrees. Angle A, 20. Angle B is 40. And angle C equals to 180 degrees minus 20 plus 40. It comes out to be 120 degrees. You may also obtain from here angle C equals to 3 times angle B. बहुत सारे रिलेशंस बन रहे हैं आपके पास यहाँ पे, एंड देन यू कैन यूज एनी इन ऑर्डर टू फाइंड आउट योर इक्वेशंस, फाइंड आउट दी मिसिंग एंगल्स. इज एनीवन राइटिंग दिस डाउन?
यस मैम.
यस मैम. Next, consider second question. So this is a conversation between two friends. One says, give me 100, friend, I shall then become twice as rich as you. The other replies, if you give me 10, I shall be 6 times as rich as you. Tell me what is the amount of their capital, respective capital. So let's represent the amount with each friend as X and Y. Friend 1 has X rupees and second friend has Y rupees. So you have to form equations if any of them borrows some money from the other. So first one, let's see if anyone has tried this.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Question number 2. In first case, can you tell me who is lending the money and who is borrowing?
X is borrowing and Y is lending.
So this amount which one of the friends lends will be added to the other person. So if Y is lending 100 rupees and X borrows that 100 rupees, what happens with the new capital they have? What's the relation between the new capital? Second friend se 100 rupees leke humne first friend ko de diye. Y minus 100 aur X plus 100 ho gaya. Ye new capital hai unki. The first friend said, I will be twice as rich as you. So the amount of money with the first friend will be equal to twice the amount of money with the second friend.
simplify and obtain the equation. In the second case, the second friend says, if you give me 10 rupees, the second friend is now asking the first friend that if he gives 10 rupees to him, so x se hum 10 lenge aur y ko de denge, and the second friend now is 6 times as rich as the first one. Is it clear how we have formed our equations? Simplify and obtain the equations. Tell me, what are the equations formed?
2y minus x is equal to
2y minus 300 minus 2y equals to
x minus 2y equals to 300.
Let's give it a minute. Guramrit, can you answer what is the equation formed?
X minus 2y is equal to minus 300.
The second one?
6x minus y is equal to 70.
Let's give 2 minutes for those who are solving this, and then I'm going to ask the answer. Sahipreet, Ansh again is not online. Sahipreet, Rashika. Nimar, Arshpreet,
yes, ma'am.
Let us solve key equations.
No, I'm doing.
Okay. Janvi, roll number 19.
Yes, ma'am.
Beta, solve ki aapne equations.
Yes, ma'am.
Can you tell me what are the values of x and y?
Ma'am, value of y is 170.
Okay.
Oh, ma'am, and x is I'm calculating.
Okay.
Ma'am, it's 40.
Okay, it's 40. Akam?
Yes. Yes, ma'am.
Beta, did you solve this?
Doing, ma'am.
Which method are you using?
Ma'am, substitution.
Can you tell me how you have used substitution? I usually do with elimination. Help me write down the answer the way you are doing. Aapne abhi tak jitna kaam kiya hai, batao zara.
Sure, ma'am.
Kis variable ki value replace kiya aapne? Akam,
करमन जोत करमनजोत सिंह Has anyone done this with substitution other than Akam?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, Daksha has done. Daksha, can you tell me which value you have replaced from which equation?
Ma'am, from first equation, value of x. I have taken value of x, then put it in the equation 2.
Okay, you put it in equation number 2. Akam, is this how you have solved? I hope you are aware if you are saying substitution, how we use substitution.
Ma'am, I was trying from second equation.
Okay. So have you obtained the value of the variables?
No, ma'am, I have substituted y and finding the value of x from second equation.
Okay. So those who are doing it right now, I hope they have done whichever method you have used. Please make sure you're aware. I think all your teachers have made it compulsory to keep your videos on, and I'll be doing the same thing. Because the students are not answering again. I have like called out Anshav to hota hi nahi online. Sahib Preet again not responding. And just for the sake of answering that, yes, we have done, you can say anything. I'm not sure if you're doing it at all or not. Question number one, very important. First two questions of this exercise are extremely important. The ages of two friends, Ani and Biju, differ by 3 years. Ani's father, Dharam, is twice as old as Ani, and Biju is twice as old as his sister, Kathy. The ages of Kathy and Dharam differ by 30 years. Find the ages of Ani and Biju. So we start by representing the ages of these two. From there, we can find out how
Excuse
old...
Me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, when will you send the assignment of this chapter?
I'll share it today.
Okay, ma'am.
With the help of Ani's and Biju's age, we can find out how old Dharam and Kathy are. Dharam is Ani's father and Kathy is Biju's sister. Then the second equation will be formed by writing down how, what is the difference between Kathy and Dharam's age. Since we will be writing down the difference, we need to keep in mind out of the two people jinka hum age difference likh rahe hain, unme se elder kaun hai. So amongst the friends, any of the two could be elder, whereas amongst, between Kathy and Dharam, for sure Dharam will be elder. Am I right here? इक्वेशन जस्ट बी अ लिटिल केयरफुल इसकी मॉडिफाइड फॉर्म में आ जाता है नेम्स रिप्लेस कर देते हैं या थोड़ा सा एज डिफरेंस चेंज कर देंगे एंड यू हैव टू कंसिडर बोथ केसेस आइदर ऑफ द टू फ्रेंड्स कुड बी एल्डर सो लेट्स राइट डाउन So there are two possibilities right here. First one is if Ani is elder, that means if x is greater than y. Your equation will be x minus y equals to 3. I'll just write it this way.
Y minus X is equals to 3.
this is just one linear equation. This is only one linear equation using the relation between the ages of the two friends. दोनों का एज डिफरेंस कितना है, 3 years का है, दोनों में से कोई भी बड़ा हो सकता है. आइदर द इक्वेशन वन इज करेक्ट और इक्वेशन टू इज करेक्ट डिपेंडिंग हु इज एल्डर वन. सो आपको दोनों केसेस कंसिडर करने हैं व्हेन यू विल बी वर्किंग विद द सेकेंड इक्वेशन यू ऑब्टेन. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू राइट डाउन हाउ ओल्ड द फादर ऑफ अनी इज एंड द सिस्टर ऑफ बीजू इज. सो धर्म्स एज, Ani's father, he is twice as old as Ani. 2x years?
Yes, ma'am.
Kathy's age?
Y by 2.
Y by 2.
Since Biju is twice as old as his sister, that means Kathy's age is half the age of Biju. Now the difference between these two, difference between their ages, it's given as 30 years. This is equation number 3. You may simplify this. 4x minus y equals to 60. This will be equation number 3. You have to solve one with the third. This is one possibility. If Ani is elder, तो आपकी जो linear equations आपको solve करनी है वो first और third है. और अगर Biju elder है उस case में you will be working with equation number 2 and equation number 3. You have to show the work for both and then obtain your answer. Solve equation number 1 and 3. Obtain the answers, obtain x and y, then solve equation number 2 and equation number 3, obtain x and y. If I had to solve the first one with the third one, I think I can just subtract equation number 3 minus equation number 1. So these are the ages of the two friends. The elder one is 19 years old. The younger one is 16 years old. And if you're working with equation number 3 and equation number 2, I can write this as, this is equation number 2. Let's add equation 2 with equation number 3. Now the elder one is 24 years old and the younger one is 21 years old. You have two possible answers for the ages of the two friends.
Ma'am, I didn't get it.
You are talking to two friends, Ani and... Yes, Mridu?
Ma'am, I'm getting answer as 22 years and 19 years. What's equation 2 and 3?
For equation number 2 and equation number 3?
Yes, ma'am.
Has anyone else solved it? Tell me if the answer is different.
Yes, ma'am. It's correct. Is 21 and
24. Yes, ma'am, it's correct.
21 and 24.
Okay. Let's go over the question once again. They are talking about two friends, Ani and Biju. हमने एक फ्रेंड की एज एक्स ली है, दूसरे की वाई ली है. इन दोनों में से कोई भी बड़ा हो सकता है. अकॉर्डिंगली हमारी इक्वेशन बनेगी द डिफरेंस ऑफ द एजेस फॉर द टू. आइदर इट विल बी एक्स माइनस वाई इक्वल्स टू थ्री अगर अनी एल्डर है x इज ग्रेटर और द अदर पर्सन इज एल्डर इन दैट केस इट विल बी y माइनस x इक्वल्स टू 3. अगर देखो फ्रेंड्स की एज चेंज होगी तो रिस्पेक्टिवली फादर की एज भी अफेक्ट होगी और सिस्टर की एज भी अफेक्ट होगी. दैट्स व्हाई यू हैव टू वर्क विद बोथ पॉसिबिलिटीज. इफ द फर्स्ट फ्रेंड इज एल्डर तब फादर की एज क्या होगी और दूसरे फ्रेंड की सिस्टर की क्या एज होगी. द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द एजेस ऑफ द फादर एंड द सिस्टर इज 30 ईयर्स. यू फॉर्म एन इक्वेशन, यू सॉल्व दैट pair of linear equations obtained. Then you consider the other possibility. What if the second friend was elder? In that case, obviously, friends ke ages agar hum change kar rahe hain, to father ki aur sister ki age again affect hogi. But still the difference of their ages comes out to be 30 years. You have to take again the equation formed from the father's age and the sister's age, the equation number 3, with the equation where you are saying that the second friend is elder. एंड अगर आप ये कंडीशंस अप्लाई करते हो एंड यू ट्राई टू सी विद द एजेस यू हैव ऑब्टेन्ड तो आपकी सारी कंडीशंस वेरीफाई होंगी. जो फ्रेंड्स हैं उनका एज डिफरेंस कितना है, आप फादर की एज और सिस्टर की एज कैलकुलेट करो एंड यू विल सी द डिफरेंस बिटवीन देयर एजेस इज 30 इयर्स. यूजुअली आपके पास जब आप नंबर्स के साथ काम करते हो इस तरह का सिनेरियो होता, वन आंसर यू कुड बी जस्ट इंटरचेंजिंग देम. आपके पास अगर नंबर्स की बात होती, इस केस में हम एज की बात कर रहे हैं एंड एजेस फर्दर अफेक्ट द एजेस ऑफ टू अदर पीपल. दैट्स वाई यहाँ पे दो आंसर्स आ रहे हैं आपके पास. अगर सिर्फ फ्रेंड्स की एज की बात की होती और फर्दर उन्हीं की एज का कोई रिलेशन दिया होता तब आपके पास एक ही आंसर होना था. वन ऑफ द फ्रेंड्स विल बी 19 इयर्स ओल्ड, द अदर वन विल बी 16 इयर्स ओल्ड. बट हियर सिंस द एजेस आर अफेक्टिंग द एज ऑफ टू अदर पीपल और फिर उनकी एजेस का कुछ रिलेशन दिया हुआ है, इसलिए आपके पास यहाँ पे दो आंसर्स आ रहे हैं. काव्यम बेटा, कुड यू स्पेसिफाई विच पार्ट इज नॉट क्लियर टू यू?
Ma'am, now it is clear.
Anyone else? Mridul, beta, aapka answer verify hua?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Third question. A train covered a distance at a uniform speed. If the train would have been 10 kilometers per hour faster, it would have taken 2 hours less than the scheduled time. And if it was slower by 10 kilometers per hour, it would have taken 3 hours more. Find the distance covered by the train. You only have to find out the distance covered by the train. We have to form linear equation in two variables. So this is actually giving you relation between three values, distance, speed, and time. You could assume any of the two with two variables and then form your equations. The best option would be to represent the time taken and the speed at which the train is normally traveling. The regular speed and the regular time. Fir aap speed change karke kitna time change ho raha hai. Dono cases mein distance remains the same. Tell me if this is correct.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
You can now form equations considering the two cases. If the speed changes, how much time changes? The new speed in case number one is x plus 10. If the speed increases, the time is reduced by
y minus 2.
2 hours. Time is reduced by 2 hours. The distance will still be same. The distance is still going to be xy. You cannot say it's new distance. Distance is still equal to the original distance covered. Form your equation. Same way. Second case, if the speed is reduced by 10 kilometers per hour, the time increases for the journey. By 3 hours. Distance still is same as the original one. Form second equation and then solve to find out x and y. Keep in mind, once you obtain x and y, you have to find out the distance covered. Tell me if it is clear how we have formed the equations. Rest it solving. Inverse proportions hai aapke paas yahan pe. The product will be same in either case. What is the first equation formed?
Minus
x plus 10 y is equal to 20.
Okay, let's ask somebody else. Aryan Madan?
Yes, ma'am.
Beta, did you solve these questions?
Ma'am, I am doing.
Rajvansh?
Yes, ma'am.
Beta, have you solved these?
No, ma'am, I'm doing.
Okay. Manya?
Yes, ma'am.
Beta, did you obtain simplified equations or you're working on it?
Ma'am, yes. Ma'am, the first equation is minus 2x plus 10y equals to 20.
Okay.
And second is 3x minus 10y equals to 30.
All right. Kindly check. These are the equations you have obtained?
Yes, ma'am.
You may simplify the first one if want. And then when you work with it, what are the values for x and y?
X is 50, y is 12.
That means the speed of the train is 50 kilometers per hour and the time it takes for the journey is 12 hours. So what's the distance? 50 multiplied
600 kilometers.
600 kilometers.
We'll probably be left with fourth question, but that one is also to be done exactly like this one. Isi tarah ka milta julta concept hai usme bhi aapke paas. Yahan pe aapke paas distance jo tha traveled wo same tha. If you change the speed, obviously the time taken for the journey changes. The distance is still the same. So you form the equation using that. Can we take up the next question? If you have solved
yes,
this.
Yes, ma'am.
Question number fourth. The students of a class are made to stand in rows. Three students are extra in a row, there would be one row less. And if three students are less in a row, there would be two rows more. Find the number of students in the class. So the number of students in the class can be obtained by finding the product. If we know how many rows are there and how many students are in each row. Agar class ko arrange kiya gaya hai five rows mein और हर रो में 10 स्टूडेंट्स हैं. कैन यू टेल हाउ मेनी स्टूडेंट्स आर देयर?
50
students. We will be using this relation in order to find out the number of students. Aur hum represent kya kya karenge. We will assume how many rows are there and what is the number of students standing in each row. For two separate cases, make two separate equations using this relation. Number of rows multiplied with number of students in one row will give you the total number of students in the class. Originally, it will be XY, just like the distance you have taken in question 3. Give it a try. We will discuss this. And tomorrow, we will be starting with chapter number 4.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.